بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
رمضان Picks.
Assalaamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to another episode of Ramadan Picks. In the earlier video of mine, I spoke about the physical benefits of fasting, and in this video, inshallah ta'ala, I hope to outline the spiritual benefits of fasting. Firstly, let's mention a few narrations of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in regard to the virtues of the month of Ramadan. Narration number one. When the month of Ramadan starts, the gates of paradise are opened and the gates of hell are closed and the devils are all chained. This particular hadith has been recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Hadith number two. Whoever fasted the month of Ramadan out of sincere faith, i.e. belief, and hopes for a reward from Allah, then all his past sins will be forgiven. And this particular hadith has been recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari once again. Hadith number three. There is a gate in paradise called Ar-Rayyan. And those who observe fasts will enter through it on the day of Qiyamah. And none except them will enter through it. It will be said, where are those who used to observe fasts? They will get up and none except them will enter through this particular gate. After their entry, the gate will be closed and nobody will be sent through it. This hadith too has been recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari. Hadith number four. There are two pleasures for the fasting person. Twin joys basically, one at the time of breaking his fast and the other at the time when he will meet his Lord. Then he will be pleased because of his fasting. This hadith has also been recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Hadith number five, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, every good action is rewarded by 10 times its kind, up to 700 times except fasting, which is for me and I shall reward it. And this hadith is recorded in the book of Imam Malik rahimahullah, the Muwatta of Imam Malik. Hadith number six, whoever prayed at night in the month of Ramadan out of sincere faith and hoping for a reward from Allah, then all his previous sins will be forgiven. And this hadith is recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Hadith number seven, by him in whose hands is my soul, the unpleasant smell coming out from the mouth of a fasting person is better in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the smell of musk. And this hadith has also been recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. So as you can see, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the narrations are many and beautiful in regard to the virtues of fasting. Now, let's talk about a few of the spiritual benefits that can be reaped through fasting, inshallah ta'ala. Benefit number one, which is the primary benefit, taqwa. This is the goal behind fasting, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he states in the Noble Quran in regard to fasting, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا O you who have brought in iman, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ Fasting has been prescribed upon you all, just as how it was prescribed upon the people before you all. And now comes about the purpose, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ So that you inculcate taqwa, so that you bring in taqwa, so that you become from the people of taqwa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the people of taqwa. So what is taqwa? Let me quickly define taqwa. Taqwa can be translated as the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It can also be translated as the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of our maker. Now, there are scholars who state that it is the marriage of the two, and I personally feel that that is the best way of defining taqwa. So taqwa is something that has to dominate our lives, it has to govern our lives and control our faculties, control our lives, so that we live lives that are pleasing unto our Maker subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, now moving on to benefit number two. Fasting acts as a protection from other sins. Fasting acts as a shield and protects us from other sins, as has been mentioned by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a particular hadith where he is reported to have said, fasting is a shield or a protection from the fire and from committing sins. And this particular hadith has been recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, if I'm not mistaken. So now the principle of fasting is to suppress our desires, is to control our nafs and recognize our inner self. Moving on to benefit number three. Fasting helps us to develop patience and practice self-restraint. The Prophet ﷺ is reported to have said, whoever does not give up false statements, i.e. telling lies, committing evil deeds and speaking bad words to others, Allah is not in need of his fasting, i.e. his leaving of food and drink. And this hadith is recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Fasting is also referred to as a month of patience, as it teaches us patience, which is such a beautiful quality. Experts tell us that those who can control their desire of hunger can control all other desires and feelings, be it anger, happiness, sorrow, grief, etc. Hence, fasting is a comprehensive method of learning patience. And as believers, it is of utmost importance that we inculcate patience into our lives. Next in line is number 4. Fasting helps us to understand the difficulties of others, those who may be less fortunate than us. It helps us to sympathize and empathize with others. Fasting brings out the charitable side in us. It nurtures strong feelings of gratitude, thankfulness, and shukr unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The final benefit that I would like to touch on for this video is that fasting helps us to strengthen our link with our Maker. Why? Because during the month of Ramadan, like I mentioned earlier from the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the devils, the shayateen, are all shackled up, they're all chained up. So the influence of the devil is very much less during the month of Ramadan. So it is a beautiful opportunity for us to enhance our relationship with the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to enhance our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through prayer and dua. So let us seize this opportunity. Let us not let the month of Ramadan slip away from our fingers. Let's strive to enhance our relationship with the Quran and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah azza wa jal help us all to do so. May He make us from the people of taqwa, and may He make us from the victorious and successful ones. Ameen. Please share this video around as much as possible to inspire others and to share in on the reward. I look forward to talking to you all in another video soon, inshallah ta'ala. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.